Okay, my brothers and sisters, I pray that the Holy Spirit of God would lead us and guide us into all truth and understanding in Jesus Christ's most holy name. I pray for each and every one of you and everybody who is led here by the Holy Spirit of God, that he would cover you with his cleansing blood and his protective blood covering. In Jesus' name I pray. Make sure you're putting on the armor of God daily. The attacks from the enemy have ramped up. I took my wife out to celebrate our anniversary, and we were getting something to eat, some pizza, and we were getting ready to take it back to our room because we got a little hotel for the day. My kids live at the house with us, so we just wanted to have my older boy in charge of the kids here, and we just wanted some peace and time for ourselves. And we went in and got the pizza, and as we were exiting, somebody walked up to me and was, I said, "Hey, did you just get a pizza?" And I said, "Yeah, I just got a pizza. It's really good. You should go try it out." And he goes, "Well, I'm going to take yours." And I said, "I don't think so. I don't know what you're talking about, but I guess it's right over there if you want to go buy some." And he's like, "No, I'm going to take yours, And he was a big guy. I'm 6'2", and was bigger than me. And I said, "No, you're not going to take it. And you just must pray the armor of God upon yourselves daily. Trust me." Luckily, there was people around that when he made a move on me, that I was able to bring my shoulder up and into his solar plexus to push him back until the security came by and grabbed him. But I'm telling you, it's crazy out there. And I told my wife, as we were on the way there, I was telling her some of the things that were going on. And she couldn't believe it. She said, out of nowhere, she goes, "I've never seen anybody do something like that." And it was scary, but I was calm at the same time. And I believe that the Holy Spirit of God was looking out for me. I felt no fear. And he was with me in my time of need. So I'm praying for each and every one of you. And we have a word today from our sister, Julie Wedby, from Behold I Come. Earthquake and tsunami. On the night of May 11, 2019, I had a short dream of an earthquake and subsequent tsunami. I find myself running to warn my children that this was about to happen. And there were only precious few moments to prepare. By the time I arrived at home, where they were visiting their friends to warn them, until the events happened, was only minutes, literally. We as believers were protected, but the devastation was massive. I asked Father this morning, as soon as I woke up, if he wanted to speak to this. He has given me many warnings like this to post, and he has been so merciful in warning us to prepare, first and foremost spiritually, then physically as we are led. I wondered if he is going to continue to warn, because he has already given us so much warning. But because of my position as a watchman, he reminded me to continue to warn until he tells me to stop. And so I will obey. He's not given me the sequence of what judgments come first, only to be ready at the very moment, because judgment is set and it is here. Yahushua speaks. "Wake up, wake up. It has been decreed. What has been sown will now be reaped. The harvester comes to gather his harvest, and the chaff will be thrown into the fire. Repent, repent. Judgment is at hand. Many, many tekel upsharon. The tempest is here. Hear my voice." There is only one safe place to be, and this is in the center of my heart and my will. You will find no refuge in the idols of this world. My warnings have repeatedly fallen on the spiritually dead, and I will now act. To those who are my disciples, I say the fuse has been lit. Follow the instructions I have given you in your secret place with me. Jesus Christ. And trust in no man and trust in no woman, but put your full faith and trust in Jesus Christ, our risen King and Savior. And go to him in your prayer closets and seek confirmation from the Holy Spirit of God on every word. in Jesus' most holy, holy, holy name.
And I pray that Father God in heaven would cover you and your loved ones with his holy fire hedge of protection from his throne room, round about you on all sides, far above you and far below you. I pray that he would cover your places of work and worship. I pray he would cover your home and your vehicles,
your pets and provisions, your children, their schools and their activities.
I pray he would hide us from our enemies,
and that he would protect us from all electronics we encounter throughout the day.
In Jesus Christ's most holy, holy, holy name. And just know this, family, that our enemies' attacks have ramped up. So put on your armor
of God every day.
Be calm and use the word of God, the word of truth and the word of life in all your situations in Jesus Christ's most holy, holy, holy name. He's made us more than conquerors in Christ Jesus who lives within us. Glory to God in the highest, for he alone is worthy of praise.
I love you all, my brother and my family. Amen.